5, 6, 7, 8, 9, y 10.
And then there is separate
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
there is no
8, 9, 10.
Of star sound. And this is?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, y 10.
So how many lines of code do you think this might have required? Any idea? Any wild guesses? Let's do an auction here. Who's first? Let's do an auction. Okay, 100. 101. 102, come on. Lila. Auction. Come on, loudly. 102, 100. Before I say 103, someone has to say it. Come on. Don't you know the rules of auction?
20. 20.
Okay, 20. We have 20 here. 21. 22.
30.
30. 31. 47. 1. 47. 2. Come on. Any girl? I mean, there's no money required, so anyone can try. Don't be afraid. 71 we have. 72. Okay. No bidding now? Okay, I'll bid. One line of code. So this was done using just one line of code. And this is that line of code. Amazing, isn't it? So this is all done using training. So first we have to train some machine learning algorithm, and then we just, the implementation hardly takes any code. The training itself is very heavy. I mean, it takes a lot of data and it takes a lot of time, but we with GPUs these days, we have very powerful GPUs these days from NVIDIA. The training also is taking less time. Earlier, I myself on this laptop used to do training of some machine learning algorithm for 1 week. And I have bought a desktop computer now. I'm not bragging, but I got a GPU worth 75,000 rupees. So it does it in hardly 10 minutes. This laptop did it in 1 week, the training part. So exponentially the capacity of graphic cards is increasing. And you could do what you could do 3 months ago or 6 months ago, you could do half the time now. So that is the rate of, advances in computer vision or in graphics hardware, basically GPU hardware. Earlier GPUs were only used for gaming. These days scientists have found that GPUs are the best candidate to do training in computer vision. That's why they are employing they are buying graphic cards not for gaming but for training of machine learning algorithms. Anyone has seen or bought a Bose system headphone or something? It costs a bomb, right? I mean, it is very, very costly. Frankly speaking, most Indians can't afford it. Any reason why that is so? Why is the Bose sound system so costly? Yeah. You see, Amar Bose, he was an Indian origin person at MIT. He passed away recently. Before passing away, he left his fortune to the MIT college. He gave millions of dollars to the college. And he, in probably 1950s or 60s, he did his PhD. And he employed a very nice algorithm to cancel noise. Okay. So noise cancellation is the USP of Bose systems, and that is the reason why they are so costly. So what he did is, I'll just show you what he did. So suppose this is the music that you want to hear. Suppose, okay. And then if you are in a bus or a train, you have noise over it. So the sound becomes like this, jittery. Or if it is coming through a radio, so it might be affected by noise. What Bose did was, he used a system to cancel out. So suppose this is the wave of noise. He developed a system to, Suppose this is the noise, we developed a system to cancel noise actively. Okay, then and there. So, see, electricity is almost instantaneous. There's no lag in electricity. So this is, so he produced an anti-noise and applied it with the the sound signal, and the result was that instead of this, you get a very smooth and nice sound. So earlier he did it by, you know, all Bose, these days all headphones or all speakers have a built-in microphone, and that microphone takes the noise and uses that noise to build the anti-noise, and then that is cancelled out. So still, earlier there used to be a lag between this noise and anti-noise. So earlier it used to be like this. So noise was produced and anti-noise was produced slightly later. Very slight variation. Time lag. Because we have to, actively produce the anti-noise. But these days, using machine learning, the anti-noise is predicted. So what, earlier, suppose you move into a train, and it will first hear the train's sound and it will find out the periodicity in that sound. And as you know, train sound is almost periodic. It will predict or produce the anti-noise by prediction. So that is how, it works. And that is the reason why those systems are so costly. So we have very good, how many of you follow Quora.com? I think every one of you should sign up for Quora. It's a treasure trove of knowledge. So they have an answer on Quora. A Bose employee has written this answer. I'll not show it to you now. Then there are several applications. But I'm afraid that we'll fall short of time. But I'll try to show you as many as possible. So how many of you had problem learning mathematics in school or even now? Failed in M1, M4, M3, or passed at 40? Anyone? I don't expect you to raise hands. It would be embarrassing, certainly. So, maths is inherently one thing. Except, just like we can see videos and music very easily, effortlessly, we can understand it. Maths is something we cannot understand easily, intuitively, because maths wasn't discovered 540 million years ago. It was discovered fairly recently. Hardly 500 years ago, okay, or 2000 for that matter. So we don't have an intuitive understanding of mathematics. So that is the reason we found mathematics to be difficult. Had we many of us are afraid to ask teachers in class, ये कैसे किया? ऐसा लगता है teacher हंसेगा, इतना भी नहीं आता क्या? It is possible. So we are afraid to ask in class. So what if we had a tutor like this? Where we could be taught instantaneously. So 5x + 7, it is giving the value of x. Projects that you can do to this this kind of effect. fish to travel by itself around the room. Okay. You don't have an aquarium which is room size, but you want the fish to travel across. How will you do it? So put wheels under the fish, but then fish dies if it comes out of water, right? So someone did this really awesome fun project. So he built a small water cannon which carried, which will shoot the squirrels as soon as they come near those plants. We'll just see a short part of this. This is the entire video, but it will take a lot of time. I'll just show you the important part of it.
Alright, hello everyone. This talk about how you go about that. I'm not bad. Analysis book. Profile or region tricky.
So have you found out how which are the birds which come often?
So mount that gun. Serial passing the device that you I've used the tender fans that way. It's good.
AI was coined around the word artificial intelligence was coined around 1950s. Okay. Have you heard the name of Alan Turing?
Yes.
Watched the movie Imitation Game? Anyone?
Yes.
Okay. So if you have not watched, probably you should. So Alan Turing was one of the pioneers of artificial intelligence. So these days, even when we have to say that if to find out if a machine is as capable as a human, we have named that machine after Turing. So we call it a Turing machine. Turing machine is one which, if you chat with that machine, if you chat with that chatbot, you will not understand if it is a human or a machine chatting. So it will just be so good, so real. And if a machine can achieve that level of efficiency in chatting or talking, then that machine can be called as a Turing machine. So this was 50s, 60s, I mean even during World War time he did a lot of work. Then in 1970s, 80s, Professor Jeffrey Hinton, who is like the Rajnikant of AI, he can do everything basically. I mean literally people consider him like Rajnikant of AI. And he, along with professors like Jan LeCun, who is the head of Facebook AI research lab, FAIR lab, these people in 70s and 80s found out something which is called as neural network, and they basically also introduced something called as back propagation. So back propagation is what makes these algorithms really, really efficient. So it's almost like it's the Ramban Ilaj of all problems, deep learning, almost, I mean. And but then what happened since 70s and 80s, what happened that till now we didn't hear the word AI so much? The reason, I mean, this part, I mean, typically in AI culture, we call this part as AI winter. Winter is coming. So since 80s there was winter till about 2012. In 2012, what happened was suddenly we had a lot of data. One thing, like ImageNet was made in 2007, Dr. Lee said. Then we had what is called as extensive GPU power, hardware power. The hardware was extremely cheap and extremely capable. So this happened in 2012. ImageNet was for the first time almost cracked using deep learning. ImageNet, the problem is that, I mean, research universities and companies compete with each other based on ImageNet. So they have benchmarks. Kisne sabse acha prediction kiya? Okay. So ImageNet has 15 million images, right? So out of those 15 million images, some data is taken at random, and some companies, I mean, each company tries to make an algorithm such that it will make the prediction as correct as possible with the least error or classification of what is there in that image. So in 2012, Jeffrey Hinton and his team cracked the ImageNet problem, and the efficiency grew multifold. And that is the reason why we are hearing deep learning so much these days. So these days, I mean, just like we saw in Dr. Lee's TED talk, Dr. Lee's TED talk, we'll see someone has made a neural talk and walk. So as you walk, the software will describe what is there in an image. So he is walking and the description comes here. So it is so instantaneous. He's carrying a laptop, obviously. Now he goes to two policemen who are eating, having breakfast, and they just are surprised how it is working so instantaneously. Yeah.
It's trying to figure out who you are.
You gotta test the machine. Man, holding a
offer. I'm really surprised how this is happening so instantaneously. Then there is, to get you started, the best possible thing would be to, you know, learn OpenCV. OpenCV is a library developed by Intel earlier. Then it was nurtured by Hilo Garaj, and now it is run by ITSIS, a Russian organization. And OpenCV has around 5,000 inbuilt functions to help you do image processing easily. And it is open source, so you can also find out how it is doing it internally. Okay. So I'll just show you how capable OpenCV is. Are you getting bored? So this is 2014 GSOC video. GSOC, anyone knows what is GSOC? So how many of you have participated? None? Why? There's no reason you shouldn't. There's no reason only IITs should take the flag of India, right? MIT takes it in Robocon, why not everywhere? Or why not us everywhere? person was removed.
With a small camera mounted on eyeglasses that recognizes text and objects and speaks to the wearer through a discrete bone conduction earpiece.
Computer vision is a field of computer science that teaches computers to see. We are harnessing this technology to help the 280 million people in the world who experience a significant loss of vision.
Hi, my name is Devorah Shiatia. I have degenerative myopia, along with retinitis pigmentosa. ORCAD has been such a great part of my life, socially. I just remember arriving at the restaurant, and my friend requested menus, and I began to read what was on the menu. And my friend stopped, and she was shocked. She said, "Are you reading that?"
Devorah's eyesight has deteriorated rapidly over the past few years.
It was such a liberating feeling. I didn't have to worry about my friend being concerned with my disability or taking her time to go over the information with me. It was just so wonderful. My friend was so excited. And we were able to continue our conversation. We were able to talk freely without any focus on my disability.
My name is Moshe Fisher. I'm originally from Newark, New Jersey. Using ORCAD for the first time, I was shocked by the technology. Now it's become almost second nature. It's like having a friend meet you.
Moshe has been legally blind from childhood and has been using ORCAD for a few months.
Reading the newspaper has become a really relaxing experience. I'm able to sit back, scan the newspaper quickly, read it in a comfortable easy chair rather than sitting at a table and holding a magnifying glass. I have found that it's opened up new possibilities for me, such as using smartphones, which I couldn't use before, efficiently reading email rather than having to go back and at home and use a large computer screen, and looking at store windows, window shopping, which I've never done in my life. Able to experience and feel what's going on.
He did window shopping for the first time in his life after this device.
I was sensing what I was seeing because I didn't see it.
All you have to do is point, and by responding to this simple gesture, the ORCAD device understands what you want on its own. It can be personalized by memorizing hundreds of new objects that you teach it. At this party, every name is bold. It wasn't clear which stood taller, the Corinthian columns at the New York State Supreme Court or the towering figures of New York society who mingled beneath them at the kickoff to the 12th annual Tribeca Film Festival on Tuesday night.
I'm Rhea from Visual Impaired, and I'm going to show you how the ORCAD device changed my life.
So this is her routine.
With ORCAD, find things easily.
Ocean spray cranberry juice. Out for the newest soy milk.
Making them self-reliant. They don't have to take care
of them. Captain Crunch cereal.
Oh, it recognizes products. Now let's see what's in it.
Ingredients: corn flour, sugar, oat flour, brown sugar, coconut oil.
Sounds good, I'll take it.
Apple bio soy milk.
That's what I was looking for.
So, I mean, it's a simple application. The difference between a successful application or a successful product and a not so successful product is in execution. Okay, so earlier also many people tried doing this, but none succeeded as much as this product, ORCAD product, because they executed really well, and they executed it using state-of-the-art computer vision and machine learning and deep learning techniques. Then obviously everyone knows these days Google has come up with their own self-driving cars, then Tesla has come up with autopilot. Tesla developed their autopilot technology using the technology from Mobileye. So both these companies, ORCAD and Mobileye, are from Israel, a person called Dr. Amnon Shashua. You know what is the area of Israel? It is obviously less than Maharashtra. Okay. So, and do you know how much of it is desert? So we obviously broad or feminism problem that we are facing since some years now. But do you know what is the average rainfall in Israel? Very bad. They use desalinated seawater for drinking, for irrigation, for everything. So they have, you know, they have not, they are not sitting and crying. They are finding solutions to their problems. So, frankly speaking, this is slightly political, but crying or, you know, kind of all those suicides are really, they show that we are not able to face problems. And as a society, including us, has to come up and start giving everyone the courage to, yes, we can face these kind of problems. So, this is a small demo of mobilized self-driving software.
Rear end collisions are one of the most common accidents caused by driver.
This is employed in Tesla cars.
The mobilized system continuously scans the area in front of the vehicle, detecting all types of